The video that you are about to see is the sixth chapter in my 12-part series on video production for small business owners and nonprofits. You are watching the free version that I've made available on YouTube, but if you would like to access the entire course, which includes project files, library templates, PDF guides, and a lot more, you'll find everything at the address down below, or I'll post a link in the video description. Without any further ado, let's begin the class. Hey folks, and welcome to the sixth chapter in my 12-part series on video production for small business owners and nonprofits. Today we are talking about the Ken Burns Effect, made famous by, though technically not invented by, Ken Burns. In doing my research for this class, I learned something very interesting about Ken Burns. You know what's the one credit that Ken Burns doesn't have in any of his documentaries? Editor. He's a director, producer, cinematographer, lots of other stuff. Not an editor. Has an editing tool named after him. Not an editor. Oh, the irony. The Ken Burns Effect involves panning and zooming over still images in order to give the appearance of motion. I wanted to devote a chapter of this course to the Ken Burns Effect because I think it can be a very effective tool to help tell the story of your business. To add the Ken Burns Effect to any photo, drag your image into the timeline and ensure that the playhead is over the clip. Then click on the clip so that it's highlighted, and from here we're going to click on whatever icon you see in this space. And please note, it can be any one of these three. These are the transform, crop, and distort tools. The Ken Burns Effect lives inside the crop tool, so let's click on that. Here in the preview window, we now have two boxes. One, outlined in green, represents where the frame will start. Then we have a red box representing the last frame. If you want to swap the start and end points, click this icon here at the top left. To make any adjustments, I can resize the frame by grabbing any corner and dragging it. The speed at which it takes to go from the first frame to the last frame is determined by how long you make the shot. I'm now going to click Done here at the top right. If I lengthen this clip, you will see that it slows down the momentum, whereas when I shorten it, it makes that shot very dramatic. Another fun trick that I wanted to show you is how to apply the Ken Burns Effect to the same shot twice and then reverse the motions. Let me show you what I mean. I'm going to use this stock photo of this couple with their dog as an example. Let's say I want to start with a close-up on Fido over here, and we're going to have it slowly zoom into his face. Then we're going to cut to a wide shot of the couple with it slowly zooming out. Let's create that type of shot together, and feel free to follow along at home with your own photo. For starters, I'm going to drag my photo into the timeline. Then I'll go into the crop tool and select the Ken Burns Effect and frame my shot. Okay, folks, I want to teach you a massive time-saving trick. Right now, I am teaching you this trick in the context of a still photo, but this can apply to anything, whether you're working with titles, sound effects, or music. If you ever want to duplicate anything, all you need to do is hold down the Option key on your keyboard and then drag your cursor to the right or left. At this point, I'm going to duplicate that shot by holding down the Option key and then dragging that clip to the right. Now, I'm going to change the framing so that the second shot is wider so we can see that couple, and reverse the motion so that we're now pulling back. And here is what the final results look like. See, now isn't that a bit more interesting than just one single movement? In Chapter 7, we are going to discuss all things audio, including how to add music to your project, how to adjust audio levels. I'm going to show you how to add a voiceover, which, by the way, pairs very, very well with the Ken Burns Effect, and a lot more. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. Class dismissed.